Daudi Mlaule from the University of Dar es Salaam Computing Center. I'm based at Arusha region, northern part of Tanzania. I'm here to describe the components of a computer system as a fulfillment of requirement in our course of IT Essential and A Plus certification. Warmly welcome and let us go to the course. Here is my computer system. I have already disassembled some parts. So some parts are separate, like here I'm having my power supply unit. As you can see, the power supply has input socket for 240 volts as a domestic voltage, but I'm having a voltage selector here. If I'm using 120, then I can select here by using a notch, pushing this on the other side. Then on the other side of my power supply unit, I'm having different cables for different wattages. Some of them are going to the motherboard, like this one, P1 connector. Some of them are SATA cables going to the drives, hard disk, CD-ROM, and so forth. Others are auxiliary power cable, like this one, which goes also to the motherboard. So the power supply has a function of converting alternate current AC into direct current DC. Then coming to the computer itself, I'm having the drives. These are permanent storage, internal. This is internal hard disk, and this, I'm having two of them with the SATA cables. This is a SATA cable, and it's connected to the motherboard socket down there. Also, I'm having a CD-ROM drive, an optical drive. Also has a SATA cable, goes there to the motherboard. But on the motherboard itself, I'm having RAM. You can see the random access memory module or chip. This one here, I can take it out by pushing out the notch here, this one, and also this one. Then I can take out my memory chip safely. Yeah, this is the memory, and I can read what is written here. The amount of memory, this is 1 gigabyte, and it's DDR3. So I'm putting it aside. But also I'm having a fan assembly, heat sink and fan assembly. As you can see, I'm having a fan here. The heat sink is down there, metallic material, which is aluminium. And under this, I'm having my processor, central processing unit. I'm having also other parts like GPU here, graphics processing unit, and the heat sink. But also I'm having riser card, internal riser card, which is there. This is for wireless network interface card. As you can see on the rear side, this notch is where the antenna is plugged. So after putting the antenna here, the computer can access internet wirelessly by using this card. So what you can see here is the motherboard. The greenish plate here down is the motherboard, and the motherboard has those lines which are going to different components. These lines are the buses, and so we have the bus architecture. In bus architecture, we have two main sides. We have north bridge, which connects to main memory, and you have the south bridge, which connects to input and output hub. So this is the motherboard, is seen as in greenish color, is a plastic material, and it's resting on standoffs. Standoffs can be seen under the motherboard itself, which separates the motherboard from the case. And I didn't say it before, but actually before starting this activity, I have discharged my body from the static electricity, because if I don't do that, I might destroy my components. So I have a wrist strap, anti-static, or I can touch my case. So the potential from my body can go into the case, and now I'm safe even touching the components comfortably. So on the motherboard, as I said, you can see the pathways or the circuits. These are the buses. The buses are for communication. We normally use them to communicate from one component on the motherboard and the other. When you are connecting, let's say, an external USB mouse, you are actually connecting it to the motherboard. So it has to communicate to the CPU, memory, and all other components. Now we have the types of these buses, having the PCI, peripheral component interconnect, as the old-fashioned. This was very important in connecting external devices or other items which can be made and useful to the computer. After a time, PCI was advanced and we had now PCIe, peripheral component interconnect extended. Now we can see on our motherboard, PCIe, this one here, we have two slots, the first slot and the second slot, and currently on the first slot here, the network interface card for wireless connection is connected. So you can see if you are having any other device, you are able to raise your motherboard and improve the functionality of the motherboard. But despite of the PCIe, also we are having the say another bus for AGP, accelerated graphics port. This is designed for video, having a high quality resolution video and fast one. But some of them are used, like in my computer here, this is not used because I'm having onboard video card. But if onboard video card is destroyed, I'm able to buy an external video card and connect it to AGP. So this is accelerated graphics port. In old fashion, also we had the AMR as one of the buses, that is audio modem riser. Audio modem riser was used only in some areas, but then was replaced by the CNR, that is communication and network riser. The AMR and CNR, nowadays modern motherboards are coming with more advanced features, so you can replace them with the PCI. PCI and PCIe, especially PCIe, has all the functionality of the AMR because audio and modem can be connected with the same. Also in other motherboards, we had the PCM CIA as one of the buses, which was used also for communication and network to the computer. So buses are very important. Without buses, actually the communication cannot be established. With that case, now coming to the RAM, this is the RAM here. Let me remove it from the notches, taking it out. So my RAM is safe, and this is DDR3. What I'm saying DDR3 means double data rate, dynamic random access memory. We have DDR1, DDR2, and DDR3. This depends on the motherboard specification of what amount can be contained on that motherboard. But the modern one is DDR3. So this is how the motherboard displays all the components. I've talked about optical drive, I've talked about the hard disk internal storage, I've talked about the CPU, heatsink and fan assembly, I've talked of the memory banks, these are the memory banks, and also we have a system battery here for recording the time and setting other items in the CMOS, complementary metal oxide semiconductor, which actually is a piece of hardware containing the BIOS, basic input output system. We can see here some SATA connectors, and we can see power connectors on the motherboard. We can see auxiliary connectors like this for power. We can see power cable for our fans. This is a fan for heatsink and power supply, I mean a CPU, and this is a fan for the system itself. But also we are having cables for the LEDs. These are the cables which are coming to the front side of our computer, which can display the power on or hard disk business. With all this, thank you very much. Once again, my name is Daudi Mlaule from University of Dar es Salaam Computing Center. Thank you very much.